Today we're going to talk about electronic throttle control.
I know the simple way to get rock and roll. I know the simple way to get you out of control. I can manipulate it like a doll. I say.
Now, the classic mechanica of throttle is quite simple in build, but let's take a look. So, basically, we'll have the throttle and the link. And the link will be connected to the gas pedal, or the accelerator if you prefer. And when you step on the gas pedal, it will pull this link. That will eventually rotate this throttle. And one more piece of this puzzle is this TPS, meaning the throttle position sensor. And it's nothing else than a potentiometer that changes its resistance depending on the position of the throttle. And this is needed for the ECU to calculate the amount of fuel that is needed for this amount of air. With electronic throttle it looks a little bit different. Instead of that mechanical link, now we'll have the actuator in form of an electric motor here that will now control the throttle position. So this motor will basically move it instead of the linkage. And the gas pedal is no longer just a piece of mechanics. It is an electronic gas pedal that will have embedded potentiometer, or it may be a different electronic circuit that will be seen as a potentiometer outside, but inside it's actually made from on a different principle, but it doesn't matter. Anyway, so it will act as a potentiometer. Position of the gas pedal will be then sent electrically, of course, to the ECU, and the ECU will then take this information and calculate the needed position of the throttle. It will send another electric signal to the motor, and the motor will just move the throttle body. And in order to keep the body in a correct position, the throttle, the ECU will also take the signal from the throttle position sensor. One more difference here is that the throttle position sensor will now have two potentiometers, and so will the gas pedal. This is needed for redundancy, let's say, so different ECUs from different car manufacturers will act in a bit different way here, but they will all have some precautions, let's say, or some special mechanism that will act if one of the potentiometer is, let's say, broken in any way, or the wire going to the potentiometer is broken, then it will not just, you know, go to the full throttle or close it completely. It will then use the other one, just it will limit the maximum speed or something like that. Yeah, and the same goes to the gas pedal. If one of those potentiometers is broken, then it will, let's say, you will still be able to drive your car, but with some certain limitations. Of course, if both are broken, then the ECU cannot detect the position of the pedal or the throttle anymore, and it will just stop the car, but yeah, nothing that you can do about it. Anyway, usually those potentiometers will have different characteristics or will work in opposite ways or something like that. That's why I've drawn it like this. It makes it a bit easier for the ECU to, let's say, be sure what's going on with the position of those two. So I've got one gas pedal here, it looks like that, right? Yeah, it's produced by Bosch, Yeah, this one comes from Fiat Punto, I believe. Yeah, these days most of them will be fully plastic, but I bought this one because it has this arm made of metal, which makes it a bit easier to adapt. I can just cut it and weld it if I need. Yeah, so that's how it looks. Yeah. Okay. See. There are wires, six of them, so two potentiometers, that's my drone. That's how it looks. Let's see now how it works. When you've got the vehicle that is already equipped with the electronic throttle, then of course the ECU will control that. But for my Seicento, when I'm changing the engine, well, the engine itself is actually equipped with the electronic throttle, but of course the car doesn't handle that. So I've decided to, instead of, let's say, gluing some classic mechanical throttle to the engine, I've decided to build my own controller for the throttle. And the schematic for that looks like this. Yeah, well, it may look a bit complicated, but believe me, it's actually not. Here we've got the block diagram that will explain all that. Yeah, I know you don't like it, but I'm gonna tell you that anyway. So, there are just few blocks here. Here we have the motor that controls the throttle. And it also drives this throttle position sensor that is over here, in form of the potentiometer. Okay, yeah, the signal for my throttle control will come either directly from the gas pedal, or I've also added a second input that is limited a little bit, so it cannot open the throttle completely. And this signal, this PWM signal, is coming from the ECU, so this will actually control the idle speed of the engine. Great. Okay, so both of those signals, the signal from throttle position sensor and the gas pedal, or this additional input, those signals will be filtered by a low pass filter. This is needed for getting rid of a noise that can, let's say, it will be induced on the lines connecting all this stuff. Yeah, believe me, without that it won't work at all, it will be a crap. Anyway, so it's filtered, and both those signals are going into a so-called error amplifier, and it will compare the signal from the TPS and from the gas pedal. And if, for example, the TPS is says that the throttle is opened more than we actually wanted, so the signal from the TPS is higher than the gas pedal, then it will, let's say, make the PWM signal lower. The PWM signal then controls this H bridge, transistor bridge that controls the motor, and eventually it will just tell the motor to move the throttle a bit towards the closed position. And in the other way, when we want it to be opened more, we step on the gas pedal, the signal here will be higher than that, the error amplifier will then increase the PWM signal, and via this transistor bridge the motor will move the throttle to the open position. Yeah, there is really not much more to it. There is also this adjustment segment here that just makes it possible to adjust all those stuff, and the very important protection block. This block can basically disconnect this whole bridge, so it will completely shut down the motor that will move the throttle to the fully closed position, because there is a spring connected to the throttle that moves it in case where there is no power to the motor. And what this protection does, it let's say, monitors all the wires coming from the throttle position sensor and the gas pedal, and in the case one of those is broken in any way, or there is some kind of short circuit, it will simply disconnect the H bridge and close the throttle completely. I know this is a simplified form of protection when you compare this to the one that you can have originally in new vehicles, but at least it will not shut down the engine completely, and also it won't allow the full throttle when I really don't want that. So yeah, that should work. Now let's see it in practice. So this is the circuit, my controller, and here's the throttle. Now it's controlled by the signal generator that simulates the signal coming from the ECU, for example. Well, not exactly, because it's adjusted in a way that it can open it to a full throttle, but it doesn't matter. Anyway, as you can see, it's working really nice. I know it's on 800 millihertz. Let's speed it up. Oh yeah, it's moving. Okay, now a bit slower. Yep, it's working quite nicely. Let's check what's going on when I will disconnect one of the wires. Yep, as you can see, it's now fully closed because of the spring I told you about. Let's turn it on again. Whoops. Yep. And it's working again. Not a problem at all. I can also show you how quick it is, because it is quick. Let's disconnect it for a second. Okay. Move it to a square wave. Yep. Okay. I better hold on to that. Yeah. Oh yeah, it's quick. And now the thing that we're really interested in, so throttle controlled by the gas pedal. Yeah, I've disconnected the generator and connected the gas pedal, and let's see. Yay, it's working! You can see it's also really fast. Yeah, very good response. No problem at all. Yep, so that's it. See you next time. Oh yeah, don't forget to click subscribe and check our Facebook profile.